In this video, we will learn about the functions of the government at local level. The first question that you need to ask yourself is, what is a local government? When we say the word local, we are relating to a place which is much smaller in geographical distribution. What I mean by that is, it has to be a district or something below that, like a city, town, or a village. For administration purpose, a country is divided into states. States are further subdivided into districts. So if you look at India's map, every state is subdivided into districts. Uttar Pradesh has the maximum number of districts. So here's a list where you can see the number of districts each state has. Pause the video and have a look at it. District level is where the local government come into the picture. Generally, if you see a state, it is simply too large. Now, dividing it into districts is somewhat reasonable to operate. Now, all of this is done for effective administration, because it is generally believed that if a government is much closer to the people, the more it tends to be responsive. That's the whole idea behind having a local government, so that the government can serve the people by being closer to them. In a district, we have cities, towns, and villages that are categorized under urban and rural area. If it is an urban area, then the local governing body is a municipal corporation or a municipality or a city council. Now, all of this is actually based on the population of a place. For example, if a place has a population of more than 1 million, then that place has a municipal corporation. It is also known as Nagar Nigam or Mahanagar Palika. The largest municipal corporation are in 8 metropolitan cities of India. They are in Mumbai, Surat, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, and Pune. Likewise, if a place has a population of less than 1 million and more than 1 lakh, then that place has a municipality, also known as Nagar Palika. Generally, smaller district cities and bigger towns have a Nagar Palika. Similarly, if an urban place has more than 30,000 and less than 1 lakh inhabitants, then that place has a city council, also known as Nagar Parishad. These places are neither a full-fledged urban area nor a full-fledged rural area. It's in between. So if we have to quickly recollect, just remember it this way. A municipal corporation is for a bigger city, like a metropolitan city. And municipal corporation is also known as Nagar Nigam. After cities, we have towns. If it's a bigger town, then we have a municipality. And municipalities are known as Nagar Palika. And finally, we have places that are neither a big town nor a complete village. It's in between. These places have a city council, also known as Nagar Parishad. Now, all these three forms of local governments are further subdivided into administrative units called wards. One member is elected from each ward through a direct election. And together, all these individual wards form a wards committee. So basically, a municipal corporation or a municipality or a city council is made up of wards committee. So these are the three forms of local governing as well as administrative units. And they are very much like an urban local political unit. The reason I call them as an urban local political unit is because even they have elected representatives. We as citizens of India, we also take part in municipal elections where we elect someone who is called as corporator. So this corporator is basically chosen by a direct election for a term of 5 years. Moments back, I told you all these three forms of local governments are further subdivided into administrative units called wards. So basically, these corporators belong to each of these wards. He or she is elected by us for solving and presenting our local issues in all these three forms of local civic authorities by forming a ward committee. And I think you can pretty much understand that by electing these corporators, the entire local government is slowly emerging. So naturally, that local government needs a head or a chairman. The head of that local government is in the form of a mayor. That also means all these three local authorities have a head who is in the form of a mayor. In other words, a mayor is the head of a municipal government. Consider his or her role of that like a governor or a president at state and national level. But the actual executive power lies in the hands of a municipal commissioner. A municipal commissioner is a civil servant. Consider his or her role of that like a chief minister or a prime minister. I hope you are able to understand it in parallel terms. So this is the entire setup of a local urban government. Now let's look at the administrative setup of a rural area. This is where the Panchayati Raj system comes into the picture. As I've said, in a district we have cities, towns and villages. We saw the entire administrative setup of an urban area, which consists of cities and towns. Now let's see what the local government bodies look like at rural level. So every district has villages too, just like cities and towns. and district level government in Panchayati Raj system is also popularly known as Zilla Parishad. For rural administration purpose, a district or a Zilla Parishad is subdivided into blocks. Now, blocks are also called tehsils, talukas, mandals, subdivisions. Different states have different names. Under a single block, there are several villages. Villages are often the lowest level of subdivisions in India. The governmental bodies at the village level are called Gram Panchayat. And always remember, Gram Panchayat and Village Panchayat is the same thing. That means block level government is the link between the Gram Panchayat and the district administration. As a part of the rural local self-government, there has to be a Gram Panchayat in every village. Then every village holds a meeting which is called as Gram Sabha. Now Gram means village and Sabha means meeting. Anyone who is 18 years old or more and who has the right to vote is a member of the Gram Sabha. As I said, every village has Gram Panchayat, which is the rural local self-government. Now this panchayat consists of 5 members who have the executive authority to take decisions for the village development. If you look at the word panchayat, panch means 5 members. The president or the head of the Gram Panchayat is the Sarpanch. Now the question is, how are these members of the Gram Panchayat elected? So I have said that every village has to have a Gram Panchayat. That means a village or a gram is further subdivided into wards. At an average, a village has around 7 to 17 wards. Each ward elects a representative who is known as the ward member. They are also called as panch. These ward members or panch are elected by the local people of the village. Therefore, these members are also members of the panchayat. Now, all these ward members or panch elect a sarpanch amongst themselves, who becomes the president and the head of the panchayat. Together, they form the Gram Panchayat and they are elected for 5 years. If you can think about it parallelly, in state and central government elections, we, the citizen of India, elect an MLA and an MP. The MLAs then elect a chief minister and MPs elect the prime minister. So that's what happens at village level as well. The local people of the village elects a ward member. Since a village is divided into small wards, all the ward members together elect a sarpanch, who becomes the president and head of the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Panchayat also has a secretary, who is also the secretary of the Gram Sabha. So Gram Sabha is basically a village level meeting, if you remember that. Now this secretary is not an elected person. He or she is appointed by the state government. The Gram Secretary is responsible for calling the meeting of the Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat, and they also keep a record of the proceedings. You see, elected officials come in 3 levels, center, state and local. At center we have the MPs of Lok Sabha, then at state we have the MLAs, and at local level we have corporators in urban areas and panch members in rural areas. All these are elected members, elected by direct election. It's a system of choosing political office holders. Let me quickly make a rough outline just to summarize everything. So the administrative structure in India looks like this. At top we have the central government, below that we have the state government, and under the state government we have the local government. The local government starts at district level. As we all know that every state is divided into certain number of districts, and state is simply too large to govern. Therefore, dividing it into district is somewhat reasonable to operate. In a district, we have cities, towns and villages that are categorized under urban and rural area. If it is an urban area, then the local governing body is a municipal corporation, also known as Nagar Nigam, or a municipality, also known as Nagar Palika, or a city council, also known as Nagar Parishad. These municipal areas are further subdivided into wards. One member is elected from each ward through a direct election. They are called as corporator. And together all these individual wards forms ward committee. Similarly, in rural area, villages are categorized under blocks. Blocks are called tehsils, talukas, mandals, subdivisions. Under a single block, there are several villages. And every village has a Gram Panchayat. To elect the members of Gram Panchayat, a village is divided into wards. From every ward, a ward member is elected by the locals of the village. All these ward members are called panch, and they collectively elect a sarpanch who becomes the president as well as the head of the village or Gram Panchayat. So this is the entire administrative structure of India in brief. Overall, the aim of this video was to tell you the entire structure of local government in India. We went through everything in detail in a step-by-step manner, and I hope that you now understand what the local administration as well as government body looks like at various levels. I hope you found this video informative. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. As usual, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.